over this time. Serena's last dance is at an end.
Serena Williams, the greatest of all time, takes a final bow.
Oh, my God, these are happy tears, I guess. I don't know.
She first picked up a tennis racket at just 3 years old. Her father, Richard, had seen the prize pot for the French Open on TV and decided to raise some champions.
This girl made $40,000 in 4 days. I knew I was in the wrong business.
Serena soon made her mark, knocking over world number one Martina Hingis to win her first major title at the US Open at just 17 years old.
What does that sound like when you hear those words, 1999 US Open Women's Champion?
It's just really too exciting to compete right now.
Unleashing a big serving style that women's tennis had never seen before. Serena's only true rival on the way to total domination was her own sister, Venus, the pair facing off 9 times in Grand Slam finals.
Because she just would always beat me really bad.
Serena was a 23-time Grand Slam champion, 4-time Olympic gold medalist, 2-time non-calendar slam winner. She was ranked world number one for 319 weeks. Serena is a true trailblazer, paving the way for countless women.
Because I saw somebody look like me dominating the game, and it made me believe that I could dominate too.
My granddaughter sees Serena, she's like, Nana, I can do that, because Serena did it.
Like, she's the greatest of all time, and you don't have to put, like, black or woman or any sort of modifier in front of it.
Just 1 month ago, Serena announced after dedicating 37 years of her life to the game, she was bowing out.
It is a little soon, but it's also happy, because, I mean, this is what I wanted.
Serena Williams' impact on the world of tennis is immeasurable.
It's been the most incredible ride and journey I've ever been on. I mean, I'm just so grateful to every single person that's ever said go Serena in their life, because you got me here.
Well, earlier we spoke to Serena's Aussie coach, Rennae Stubbs, in New York. Rennae, how are you feeling?
I'll be really honest, I'm bloody exhausted. I'm so tired. It's been a, you know, emotional roller coaster the last 24 hours, obviously. You know, I would have loved to have seen Serena get through that. My other thought is great job to Ajla Tomljanović to get through an incredible match against, you know, the greatest of all time and in really tough conditions last night with all the crowd against her. And, you know, I'm happy it was Ajla, of all the people, you know, to beat her, a friend of mine. And, but yeah, a bittersweet end. But to be honest with you, it was a great week that we experienced together.
Such a huge moment for Serena. How's she feeling?
Tired. I know how I feel today. I'm exhausted, and I didn't run around for 3 hours last night. And I certainly didn't play doubles the day before and a match before the day before. I mean, she's just, it's been a lot for her, almost 41 years of age, and as I said, played over 3 hours. The longest match she's ever played at the US Open in her history. It was the last one she ever played, so it's kind of funny that it had to be that one. But, yeah, I mean, she's tired today.
I know you used this tag, but is she, in your view, the greatest of all time?
Yeah, look, I mean, the longevity of her career, the 23 Grand Slams, for me, she's the open record holder of the Grand Slams. I don't consider Margaret Courts. I mean, it's 24, and I know she has that, and it's a bit controversial for me because I just feel like she won a lot of Australian Opens without basically any international players. So for me, Serena holds the records for the Grand Slam titles, and, you know, her longevity is really just an incredible thing to behold, winning, you know, slams and dominating in your teens, in your 20s, in your 30s, and then still playing at 41. Almost 41 years of age is pretty remarkable career.
That Margaret Court record, though, is often held up. Do you think it's inarguable at this point?
Yeah, I mean, look, I just feel like 24 Grand Slams is an incredible achievement. I don't want to take anything away from what Margaret Court did, but at the same time, like I said, she, you know, count how many Australian Opens she won without a full field of international players. There were a lot. You know, players like Billie Jean King, Chris Evert, Martina Navratilova didn't even go to Australia until, you know, I believe the mid-80s or something like that. So she won a lot of her titles without full field. So for me, the greatest is the 23. 22 was the record that nobody ever thought would be surpassed in Steffi Graf. So the fact that Serena's gotten to 23 is pretty remarkable. And must I say, you know, could have probably won one or two more if she had gotten pregnant. But as I said, and I've said many times, she wouldn't give back Olympia for any amount of Grand Slams.
I can imagine it would be problematic if she would.
Yeah. You know, Olympia might be the one that might go over after her records.
Rennae, I believe we've just caught you as you're on your way out to dinner with Serena. What's the night got in store? You guys hitting the Terps?
You know, I suspect some karaokeing will be done. We'll figure out. It's not up to me. I'm just tagging along for the ride, and I suspect it might be a fun evening.
Rennae, what's on the karaoke playlist?
Well, you know, I'd like to throw a little Olivia Newton-John on there because I feel like I need to, you know, celebrate her as well after, you know, losing such a great icon. But who knows, a little Bee Gees, little Barry White, we'll see.
All right, Rennae Stubbs, have a great night. It's an extraordinary career that you're both celebrating, and thanks so much for joining us.
You're welcome. Happy Father's Day.